In this video, we will go through the process of adding a new property to SolidEdge Inspector and mapping it to a column in inspection report. This involves editing a couple of configuration files and custom report Excel template. Firstly, we need to edit the QDAS configuration file. It is recommended to take a backup before modifying these configuration files. In this file, we will add a new property at the end and name it as measuring instrument. We can copy a section and paste it at the end of the file, and then we can modify the values as per our requirement. We need to append the unique NR number value, set editable value to true, enter unique key value, and set visibility to true. This way, we are adding a new property to SolidEdge Inspection QDAS system, which can be used later in inspection reports. Save the file after modification. Next is to edit the QDAS HTR configuration file, which basically controls the CN table or spreadsheet. Open the file in editor and copy an existing section and paste it at the end. We need to append the NR value, set values of editable to true, change the key value to same value which was entered in the configuration file. Visibility should also be set to true. Update the description value to the same value what was entered in the configuration file earlier. Save the file. Next would be to add a new column in the inspection report template so that when we generate the inspection report, the new property values will be printed against this new column. Open the custom report template and add a new column with the property number and description. And also format the cells and define the border for the column. Similarly, add the same column to any other sheet if required, although this step is not mandatory. Save the file. If the file is read-only directory, we can modify the file in another directory and copy and paste the template in the custom report directory. As we modify the report template, we also need to update the .ini file, which is in the same directory. Open the ini file in the notepad and modify the values accordingly. We need to add new row cell and link it to new property value which was created, and also mention the same column name value from the custom report template. Save the file, close and restart SolidEdge so that the modified changes will also get applied to the new session. Open the same drawing in the SolidEdge, launch SolidEdge Inspector application and run create update CN list. Now open the CN table and check for the new column, that is a measuring instrument column in this case. As we define this new property at the end, it will be appearing as a last column in the CN table. As this column is editable, we can now make entry, that is add values against each dimension. In this case, let's add few values for measuring instrument type for few dimensions. We need to save these changes with the commit operation. Now, let's generate an inspection report with the custom report which we defined. In the inspection report, let's jump to report page and we can see the values of a new property which gets printed against new column cells. Thanks for watching.